Iran's new leader is Western-educated, speaks six languages, with a long resume in Iran's Islamic revolution. Unlike the abrasive Ahmadinejad, he presents a softer image. His election led some Western leaders and media to brand Iran's new president a moderate who can change Iran.
Nothing is going to change.
Hebrew University professor Moshe Sharon says Rouhani differs from Ahmadinejad in style, but not in substance.
You should expect in the coming few months some kind of an overture by this nice-looking man. He's got a fatherly face, speaks the right language, speaks the language which he knows that the West wants to hear, while exactly continuing with the plan of Iran to enrich uranium.
He's a clergy, as I said. He's a Hojatul Islam wal Muslimin, which is a high degree of clergy, not Ayatollah, but pretty high in the ranks of Shiite Islam.
Iranian expert Tamar Gindan says a cartoon posted on Facebook shows the essence of Rouhani's election, where he's shown painting a beautiful Iranian missile.
It looks much better, but it's still a missile. And he said himself that they're not going to stop the centrifuges.
While the president is the face of Iran, the real power lies with Supreme Leader Ayatollah Khamenei.
Don't think that Rouhani is going to develop his own policy. There's not going to be such a thing. He's going to present a policy which is going to continue to be created by the Supreme Leader.
Those policies include Iran's nuclear program, its support of Syria, and alliance with Russia. Rouhani also has a long history in a regime that persecutes Christians, tortures dissidents, and built the world's largest terror network. While the West takes stock of Iran's new president, both Gindan and Sharon say the centrifuges will keep spinning while Iran draws closer to a nuclear bomb.
The danger is that because he's nicer, he can buy more time. And then it might be too late.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.